So much. Nice. I'm gonna switch guitars real quick. We're Two Blue here live at Mars.
Again.
Thanks for welcoming, having us back. We appreciate
Absolutely.
It. I told my brother-in-law, we're playing at Mars on Wednesday, and he said, isn't that kind of a long ways to go for a gig? I said, yeah, but they got the best studio in the galaxy.
Nice.
It's a little thing by Albert King called Crosscut Saw. I'm a crosscut saw, baby, drag me cause you're long. I'm a crosscut saw, baby, drag me cause you're long. I cut your wood so easy for you, you can't help but say I know. I got a double-bladed axe, and it cuts real good. I'm a crosscut saw, gonna bury me in your wood. I'm a crosscut saw, baby, drag me across your lawn. I cut your wood so easy for you, and you can't help but say hot dog, hot dog. Come on, AJ. Double-bladed axe, and it cuts real good. I'm a crosscut saw, gonna bury me in your wood. I'm a crosscut saw, baby, drag me across your lawn. Yeah, I cut your wood so easy for you, you can't help but say I know. Some call me wood chopping Sam, some call me wood cutting Jim. The last little girl I got the wood for, she wants me back again. I'm a crosscut saw, baby, drag me across your lawn. I cut your wood so easy for you, you can't help but say I know. Do it again for me now. Some call me wood soaking Sam, some call me wood cutting Jim. The last little girl I cut the wood for, she wants me back again. I'm a crosscut saw, baby, drag me cause you're long. I cut your wood so easy for you, you can't help but say I know. I got a double-bladed axe, and it cuts real good. I'm a cross-cut saw, gonna bury me in your wood. I'm a cross-cut saw, baby, drag me across your lawn. I cut your wood so easy for you, you can't help but say hi, darling. Thank you.
Very nice.
Happy Hump Day, all.
Yes.
Mama, Papa, please talk to your daughter for me. Mama, Papa, please talk to your daughter for me. She done made me love her and I ain't gonna leave her be. And now, baby, please don't dog me around. I said, hey, now, baby, please don't dog me around. Well, you keep on fussing, but you're 6 feet in the ground. You better talk to your daughter. 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 She done made me love her and I ain't gonna leave her be. Talk to your daughter. You better talk to your daughter. You better talk to your daughter. She done made me love her and I ain't gonna leave her be.
Talk to your daughter.
She done made me love her and I ain't gonna Robin Ford. Thank you very much. Thank you. I think we're going to have AJ sing a song. Call Rock Me Baby.
Rock me, pretty baby. Rock me all night long. I want you to rock me, baby. Like my back ain't got no bone. Roll me, baby. Roll me like you roll a wagon wheel. Roll me, pretty baby. Roll me like you roll a wagon wheel. I want you to roll me, baby. You don't know how it makes me feel.
Down to the crossroads.
sinking down.
Slow blues. Little thing called Red House. There's a red house over yonder, babe. Lord, it's where my baby stays. I said there's a red house over yonder, babe. Lord, it's where my baby stays. About a 99, what have they? See, the cops came, took my lady away. Wait a minute, something's wrong. Hello, my key won't unlock this door. Key won't unlock this door. Got me a bad, bad feeling that my baby, she don't live here no more. She didn't say a damn thing about leaving. That's all right, I got my guitar. Thank you. Completely different. We'll do something by the Archangels called The Shape on Me. I'm going to send this out to my grandson, Marcel.
Ooh,
he is 2 going on 16.
Oh boy.
And he loves to sing and dance. So maybe this is something he can dance to.
What key is this in? I can't find it.
This is in B, like
thank
baby.
You.
I couldn't stand the heat. Just when I thought that I could never win, I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in. I went to the movies last night again. I couldn't stay long enough to see the end. There was something going on that I couldn't see. Everybody's making out on the balcony. I was missing out on the fun again, and I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in. Well, I tried so hard to get back in the race. I'd be satisfied if I could just pace. There's so much competition, but the best don't always win. I'm doing pretty good for the shape I was in. Thank you.
to a party made a few passes. One was a dream and the other was nasty. Well, I guess you know by now what I did again. 'Cause I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in. I was down like a dollar coming up against the yen. Doing pretty good for the shape I was in. I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in. I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in. I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in. I was doing pretty good for the shape I was in.
Yeah.
I love that band, Archangels. Okay, let's switch guitars real quick.
Joe's sending a lot of thumbs up.
Joe Putchender?
Yes.
Cool.
Drummer, right?
Drummer, yes.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, Blue House, I play in Blue House. We'll be at the Jewel on Friday. It's an early show. I think it's 6 or 6:30 we start.
You need another guitar stand today?
No, I got it.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe we can talk AJ into coming down and sitting in on a tune or so. So, yeah, come see us.
I will. You guys paid for the parking?
I think you get a reduced rate.
Nice. I like it.
Let's do some Rolling Stones. I saw her today at the reception. A glass of wine in her hand. Well, I knew she was gonna meet her connection. At her feet was Foot Blues Man. Said to her, you can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. No, you can't always get what you want. And if you try sometimes, you might find you hear what you need. Demonstration to get my fair share of abuse. We're singing, we are gonna rain our frustrations. If we don't, gonna blow a 50 amp fuse. You can't always get what you want. No, you can't always what you want. I said you can't always get what you want. But if you try sometime, you might find you get what you need, babe. Thank you.
prescription filled. Well, I was standing in line with Mr. Jimmy. And man, did he look pretty ill. We decided that we would have a soda. My favorite flavor, cherry red. Well, I sing my song to Mr. Jimmy. And that was all he said. I said to him, you can't always get what you want. No, you can't always get what you want. No, you can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you might find you get what you in her hand was Bleeding Mary. She was practiced at the art of deception. And I could tell by the blood on her hands. I said to her, you can't always get what you want. No, you can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you might find you get what you need. Yeah, you get what you need, babe. Oh, you get what you need.
So who's coming up after us here? Who's next on the list?
Blind Date on Saturday.
Blind Date.
Cover band does a lot of interesting kind of...
They start at the 50s and then just keep
on. They do a lot of the classic rock stuff, but not as common stuff. It's very good.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it. And then we have Charlie Burton a week from
Saturday. Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah.
Be Charlie Burton. I've known Charlie since I was like 15, so I'm looking forward to this.
That'll be cool.
That'll be fun.
He's a legend.
And we have Phil Rooney guest hosting that night. I don't know if you know Phil, but I'm sure you do. Yeah, Phil's going to be the interviewer that night for Charlie.
Cool.
So it's all good.
AJ, you want to try this midnight train?
Sure.
Better try something we haven't done, actually done yet, but we both... I kind of like this tune, so I think we're going to see how it proceeds here.
A lesser known CCR song.
Yeah, John Fogerty. And yeah, it wasn't one of his top hits.
Should have been.
It should have been, yeah. Thank you. Another one that we have done before, but not too often. But AJ likes this song, and I like it. It's not really blues, but it's a little more, it's a little more jazzy, actually. Well, it's a marvelous night for romance, with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance, beneath the cover of October skies. And all the leaves on the trees are falling to the sound of the breeze as it blows. And I'm trying to please to your calling, how your heartstrings it sings soft and low. And all the night's magic, I seem to whisper in hush. And all the soft moonlight seem to shine in your blush. Can I just have one moment dance with you, my love? Can I just make some more romance with you, my love? Well, I wanna make love to you tonight. I can't wait till the morning is gone. And I know that the time will be just right. Straight into my arms you will run. And when you're getting there, my heart will be waiting to make sure that you're never alone. There and then all my dreams will come true. Yeah. But there and then I will make it my own. And every time I touch you, you just tremble inside. I know how much that you want me that you can't hide. Can I just have one moment dance with you, my love? Can I just make some more romance with you? One more dance in the moonlight. One more. dream, but when we're out, babe, Lord, I just can't go out that door. Hey, but when we're out, babe, Lord, I just can't go out that door. Cause there's a man down there, it might be your man, I don't know. But you got me trapped, woman, on the second floor. If I get by this time, I won't be trapped no more. Raise your window, baby, I can ease out soft and slow. And your neighbors know they won't be talking about stuff then they don't know.
Expensive crew here.
Yes. I see Brent.
All right, you can switch me over anytime.
Why is that so dim right there?
I will look at that one too. Switch. Switch the camera. Hold on a second.
You're talking about playing the one song that both of our favorites and all. I forgot we
no put
Moondance on that one.
Oh.
What the hell is he talking about?
Okay, now you can hang on a second.
Where do you want us?
Oh, anywhere at the bars, but there we go. All right, Mars, you want to fire us up? We are on camera. Hey!
Hey!
Nicely done, gentlemen. So
thank
welcome
you,
back. So,
is this my good side?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's, speaking of that, so I'm working on a, I'm a software guy, as you might know, and working on a project where they have company employee photos that they keep in a database that, you know, for security and otherwise, but I was asking them, you know, I'm writing this code, and I'm like, you ever gonna update those photos? And they're like, well, I didn't think so. I said, well, Connie just retired. She was here 50 years. If she had taken her picture when she started and when she finished, probably no one's going to recognize her. I'm sorry. And I love Connie, but you got to update them from time to time. So I put,
Connie was a fetus.
Was working on, yeah, so I was working on that today, actually.
I remember that when I was working at First Data. There was some people there that had been there a number of years, and, of course, the gray hair came in and the beards came and went, and yeah, but they looked like they were, you know, 32 in the picture that they had.
Yeah, and the weight and the hair loss all the stuff. I had a lot of hair when I started there.
Well, they don't want to advertise how stressful those jobs
yes.
are.
Yeah.
That's it.
So you guys are Friday night at the Jewel.
The Blue House and the Rento Horns were at the Jewel.
Awesome.
That's a very nice
McKenna's joint. Right?
Yes, that's a very, very nice venue. Great, really nice setup for music.
Yeah, he's brought some amazing talent through.
Yes.
And it's always nice to see what they have going on down there.
Yeah.
You know, it was kind of when we were open too. We were kind of bringing in some non-traditional stuff too. So I think between them downtown and us out west, we had a pretty neat thing going. Yeah. So Brian, you got to carry all of it now.
Well, you're still doing your part, right?
We're doing this.
This is great.
Yeah, and you know, I think. Before we were rolling today, I was telling you about last weekend, the Pine Ridge thing was kind of a challenge for us because we had, I think there were 13 performers, but 9 acts. And so rotating them around the room while Corey Stroud from 89.7 The River and Larry Dunn were back here in between acts trying to, make the pitch and talk about the event. Mars and I were pretty quick on it. It was like we were going from fireplace to studio to fireplace to studio, then to the kickout, and then to the studio again. And so it was kind of fun, actually.
Did
so
you get what, donations?
Yeah,
the same
was the fundraiser
way?
Successful?
They did. I think, and I haven't checked it lately, but last I heard they had enough to cover 6 months worth of propane for a number of families for the winter. I don't know. They did pretty good.
That's great.
And they had an event Sunday at Stocks and Bonds. It was a live event.
Yeah.
We didn't get to go to that.
Yeah, so between the two, and then coming up in December, they're doing another thing you've mentioned.
We've done that one. They do it the Reverb in Benson, I think.
Okay,
yeah. It's been in the past.
So we may work with them on that again. Yeah. But it was a lot of fun. It really technically pushed every button we had. I had every mic cable we own and use in here. So I was like.
Well, just the logistics of getting that number of acts in and out is a pretty good task.
Yeah.
Somebody can't find something at the last second.
Right. And, you know, and so when one act is performing, the next one across the way is getting ready a little bit. So we're trying to let them get tuned and stuff. But we got to make sure.
Anybody want a beer?
It's all good. But
what kind of beer do you want?
Light, you got anything just light beer?
Light? We got light, yeah.
Yes, we, yeah.
So, so we've talked before, you've got Blue House, you and I had some friends in common. I don't think we talked last time. Are you a collector of turnaround riffs or not so much? Like,
am I a collector?
I mean, yeah, do you like seek those out? Like, ooh, that one's kind of neat.
When I hear one I really like, I have to learn it, you know, and I keep it in the vocabulary, but I don't know if I'm a collector.
It's kind of an interesting thing, though, right?
Because
it's like,
but that's really what makes the blues. I mean, when you're playing blues, the turnaround is important because it's some mark of distinction on the song. You know,
right?
It really does. I mean, there's so many blues, and it's all 1/4/5, and it can be major or minor. But the most distinguishing parts are the beginnings, the endings, and turnarounds, and any bridges or things like that. You really need some of that so you stand apart, your song stands apart from all the multitudes of other blues songs that can sound so similar.
Right, right. And we had a thing a long time ago. We had a little blog kind of thing called Part-Time Rockers. And we interviewed
it's
bands.
It's still out there.
Yeah, we interviewed bands that all had day gigs. But some of them had various levels of success in their life, but they were still doing it. You know, mm-hmm. they were like working at the screen printing shop during the day, and they were doing the blues at night. And I remember, I can't think of the guy's name right now, but there was a blues guitarist in Oklahoma that was his thing. He wanted to know
every turnaround riff,
he wanted to throw it, and he wanted to learn it, throw it in the hopper so that at that next gig he could pull one out that no one had heard or, yeah. you know, and it's kind of a cool thing.
Do you know Scott Keaton from Oklahoma?
I don't.
Scott's really good. I got to play with him one time. That was pretty cool.
A blues player? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's one of the things I really like about playing with Blue House and Arento on Horns is all of the songs have written arrangements that were done originally by John Novak, the original guitar player.
Who was my guitar instructor, we talked about.
And I mean, he's a great one for writing specific endings, key changes, specific endings. He wrote all the horn parts, and you know, I've played with lots of classic rock and blues bands. I really enjoy playing with the horn section. That really makes a big difference to me, so. Yeah, that is
cool.
How
many horns do you have?
We have three. We
three
have
horns.
Two saxes and a trumpet. Yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Well, and then I saw the other day Magic Slim was in someone's feed, and I used to watch Magic Slim at the Howard Street.
Yeah.
And I know he played at the Zoo Bar a lot, but, you know, the thing, that was the first time, I was really young when first saw him, I was still in high school, and I remember that the first time I saw him, I'm like, where's Slim, you know, because... The band would come out and do like 30 minutes before he'd come up, you know, and I'm like, where is he? You know,
sitting at the bar.
It was the three, yeah, it was the rhythm guitarist and the bass and drums would do about 25, 30 minutes, and then all of a sudden Slim would come up there and just kill it, and you wanted more, but it was the first time I'd ever seen that where you didn't really have the main guy there for a while.
Yeah.
He was kind of waiting for the right moment to get out there and do his thing, but
who was the one that from Canada? Was it Little Ed?
It's not ringing the bell for me.
Okay.
What about him?
I think he was from maybe Kansas City. He used to come.
No, he's from Chicago.
Was he? Oh,
yeah.
Okay. That was back in the. That was probably back in the late '80s, early '90s. He would come to Omaha pretty regular, and he was good to see.
Yeah.
I got to play with Little Ed one time. That was pretty cool. The only reason I got to play with it, I was talking to some person and somebody yelled, you're going to play with him? I no, I'm not playing with Little Ed. You know, he's world famous. And this young woman went up and caught his eye and he caught her eye and she asked. And so pretty soon I'm up there because of her. That was kind of I played a couple of songs.
Nice. Yeah. Yeah, you never know what you're going to get in those situations.
Yeah.
I remember we were playing somewhere in Benson. I don't remember which place it was. But a wedding party just dropped in, and they were all hammered and got up and started singing. I think we were doing an AC/DC song or something. And they all, and you know, you're like, at the moment when the crowd becomes part of the act, there's a little bit of fear because you don't know what's going to happen, right? And they were all hammered and singing. Do you remember that? I don't remember. I think we were doing...
at Louis?
Was it Louis?
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember where it was.
It was Louis.
You sure this really happened?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they were in and out.
I'm talking to people online.
One or two songs and they were out, I think, but they took over for
They're
a
the
minute.
Ones with the... They all had the t-shirts on. Lime green t-shirts. And they
that.
Got all on stage and it was, like, intimidating after a while.
Yeah.
But fun.
Yeah.
Like, one of the... last shows at Louis.
It was towards the end of Louis, yeah. I think they watched that place when I went there as a kid and then didn't watch it until after.
Yeah. They're coming.
That's some beer-soaked carpet for sure.
Yeah, that's right.
Carpet?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Floors, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, that was
yeah,
that Sokol. Was an interesting place.
Sokol Underground.
It's probably the worst restroom in town, I would have to say. It wasn't CBGB's, which I think I would have to
worst.
Be on my deathbed and needing to whiz to survive to go in there. I mean, it was the worst
was
place I've ever
too.
Been. Have you been? Did you ever go to CBGB's? And In New York, it was in... It was in...
Did you ever play the drumstick?
I walked by there and didn't feel like I wanted to go in.
No.
Drumstick? We played Little Bows and...
Little Bows! Yeah! Oh my gosh, that just came out.
Used to play at Little Bows all the time. And what
was Where was that?
Out by the airport, the rock club.
Okay.
Played that one too. Mm.
How about...
Black Rose.
Little Bows was on Cornhusker Highway.
I did sound for... Black Rose.
Oh, okay.
And we played Little Bones.
Did you ever do the Royal Grove? They're back.
Yes. Yeah. I heard they were back. Yeah, we used to play the Royal Grove.
It's a big room.
Crazy room.
Giant. It's in the same spot in every room.
Which one?
It's the same
location. Oh, it is. Oh, gosh, yes.
It is. Although, so the people that ran...
Do they still have that fish pond?
I don't know. The people that ran the... What was that place downtown? The trendy place we played there. I can't remember. But they left. They were in the Haymarket. It began with a V. I can't think of...
V?
Yeah. But they moved out of there and took over the Royal Grove. And Royal Grove had been closed for 5 years or so. And when the new people running it took it over, someone figured out that about half the parking lot never belonged to the Royal Grove.
Oh, really?
It belonged to the business next door. And so they had to, like, now they got this new business, they're trying to get up and rolling.
But they gotta buy
it. And they can't use the parking lot, which is connected to the building, because it's not really theirs. It was like misdiagrammed or something, and no one complained until the new people rolled in. So, wow. But that's off of Cornhusker or something, right? I don't remember. It's a different part of Lincoln.
I can drive there, but
it's
I
not
don't
downtown.
Know.
It's not.
You went to a few places in New York City. Bar.
Yeah.
You ever go to Max's Kansas City?
No, we went to a place called the Nirvana Club that was in. It was in Times Square. It was on like the 16th floor, overlooking Times Square. That was a neat place. Then we went to the Palladium. I don't know if you remember that.
Huh.
The Palladium.
Palladium.
Palladium was really cool. Really cool.
Max's Kansas City was pretty much a dive. We went during the week just to check it out. There were just a bunch of people sitting around drinking, talking about doo-wop bands and stuff like that.
I'm going to have to, when Charlie gets here, I've heard some great Charlie stories over the years. I've had some of my own.
Charlie was from Lincoln, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And I've heard some from him out of state that I'm going to have to bring up. When he's here, because
of limitations.
The one thing I remember is remember the Tylenol scare back in was it 83 or so, when they took the capsules and they put poison in them. And during the week that happened, I have to ask Charlie when he's here, but I believe he bought every bottle of Tylenol in the city of Omaha and was tossing them out as he performed at the Howard Street Tavern. We'll have to find out if that is 100% true. But Charlie's a crazy guy. And I think Jared Alberico, towards the end of Magic Slim's career, backed him up in his group. So we'll have to ask Jared about that too. So
Magic Slim's old drummer and I became friends on Facebook coincidentally today. Which is kind of weird.
Oh, wow.
What's his first name? Last name is Howell. I can't think of his name, but he's a big-time drummer. He's really good. He's played with everybody.
Oh, really? So, Brent, I got to ask you, was it traumatic to cut off the ponytail? And
no.
Did you save it?
We did save it.
Yes.
I wasn't intending on saving it, but
Earl Howell. Sorry, Earl, I just remembered his first name.
Yeah, I had been... You know, all the craziness going on, I just thought, hey, maybe I'll change things up and I'll sacrifice my tail for the cause. And I was just going to have her cut it off, and she was very careful and cut it and kept it somewhere. But 36 years I had it, yeah. And people didn't believe it when I first posted, and they were wanting to see pictures and stuff. And so
that's kind of like my beard. My son... He was in high school and never seen me without a beard, and I shaved it and then started growing it back right after I shaved it and haven't shaved since. You know, it's different lengths and stuff.
Yeah, my kids had never seen me without it. And then I had that phantom where, you know, people say you lose your leg, you can still feel it for a while. Every time I took a shower, I could still feel that thing on the back of my neck. Even though it wasn't there, it was the weirdest. It was such a weird thing. But but we still have COVID, so it didn't do it. So I thought that might be it. You know, just cut the tail. COVID's gone.
No, it didn't.
Grow it back.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not growing hair anywhere but outside of my ears and nose.
Transplant. Somebody told me once, I have a theory that you don't really start losing hair. It just starts growing in different places.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. But yeah, so obviously we're still, as we were a couple months ago, talking about the COVID thing. Still going on. It's
it ain't going away yet.
It's crazy.
Well, we'll have you back at the end of it.
Yeah, okay. When it's over, we'll have a big celebration. Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, it's been an interesting thing. It's certainly changed a lot. We talked a little bit about some of the groups doing the live stuff, streaming, and with players in their own homes and stuff. And that's amazing how the technology's improved just because of this. So we're going to dig into that a little bit. I'll give you the name of that stuff, but we're going to dip our feet into that a little bit because we have some players that traveled to Omaha that played at our place. It'd be really nice to have them sit in from their home in Nashville, whatever, and sing with cats that are in here in the basement. That'd be just amazing. So we're hoping to...
Well, I've seen some things on, like, national TV and big programs where it looks like they've been able to do that. And I always wonder, well, how did they do that with the latency and the delays and stuff? So that was an interesting conversation.
It's Wi-Fi won't cut it, so you got to have crazy fast internet to make it happen. But it actually is possible. It'd be interesting to see. You know, all the stuff I've seen so far has been pretty laid back, and probably the performers have played it a million times. So once they have the tempo, it's like muscle memory, and they're just playing it.
Yeah.
It'd be interesting to see like a speed metal band try and do something that's very intricate. You know, because then it might not hold up to that.
So maybe that's one of the good things that's coming out of this, because I mean that would give you the opportunity to play with people that you would never have the opportunity to play with.
Right.
Which is great. It's awesome. And,
right. Right. Absolutely. In fact, I'm constantly working on stuff, so we're hoping to get some of our favorite people to.
Because you can get Chick Corea lined up.
Yeah, there you go.
Wow.
To do a session with us.
Wouldn't that be cool? That would be stunning. Yeah.
Since I saw you guys last, did you guys know I became a grandpa?
No.
Yeah.
Bo Henry. Yeah.
Bo Henry.
Yeah.
My cousin's name.
Who's he named for?
It's not named for anybody, and I don't,
B-O?
Not family member, Bo for,
or B-E-A-U.
B-O.
B-O. Okay.
The football player, and for Henry Aaron, the baseball player, my son's a big sports
guy. Yeah, my cousin's name is Bo, but it's B-E-A-U.
And
you know his brother, Joe.
Yeah.
Yeah. Happy birthday, Joe,
there's
by
a
the way.
Husker plays right now is Bo, B-O-E, which
I've never seen that either. Well, cool. Well, we should assemble back in our collective spots. Everybody refill their drinks. We'll get a few more tunes underway here. I'm going to carry a camera. Which camera's live? Oh, I just walked up
the one this way.
There's Mars on camera. Okay, I'm going to get a graphic going. We'll get these guys back and rolling here.
All right. Refill your drinks, everybody. We will see you presently.
All right,
so we'll go there and re-aim the camera to here. All right, this is going to be the day of
the camera's on now.
We're on. No nudity allowed.
I never know when you're on or not.
I'm actually got a graphic up right now, but we'll be ready to roll in a second. Let's get this guy going. All right. All righty. Let's get this shot. There we go. I think I am rolling Mars, I'm ready to
make it happen. Let's go to camera 3.
Let's do Angel from Montgomery. Angel from Montgomery.
Gene, what's your favorite beer?
I'm drawing a blank.
Is it that long?
She was the Surly. Todd the Axe Man.
Todd the Axe Man. There you go. Aww.
I am an old rail man, named after my father. My home is another child that's grown old. If dreams were like lightning, thunder was desire, this whole house would burn down a long time ago. Montgomery. just give me one thing that I can hold on. This way of living is a hard way to go. This way of living is a hard way to go. This way of living is a hard way to go.
I love that guy, John. That's John Prine, and he just passed away from COVID just very early on.
Yeah.
Great songwriter. I'll keep the acoustic on. We'll do some more Stones. We'll do some Dead Flowers. Talking to some rich folks that you know. Well, I hope you won't see me in my ragged clothes. Well, you know I don't love me. Take me down, little Susie. When you're sitting back in your rose pink Cadillac, making bets on Kentucky Derby, I'll be in my basement room with a needle and a spoon and another girl to take my pain away. Every morning.
get to bruises on your grave. I won't forget to bruises on your grave. I won't forget the bruises on your grave.
Thank you very much. AJ and I are called Two Blue. We do blues and other assorted things, kind of keep ourselves occupied. I think it's your turn to sing one. Let's do King B.
King B. Stones out.
What's that?
Ready for more?
We're gonna do King B.
Okay.
King B.
Keeping me on my toe.
Yes, sir.
Well, I'm a kingpin, buzzing around your hive. Well, I'm a kingpin, buzzing around your hive. Well, I can make any baby let me come inside. I'm young and able to buzz all night long. I'm young and able to buzz all night long. When you hear me buzzing, baby, you know there's some stinging going on. I'm gonna sting her. I can buzz all night long. Well,
Well, I can buzz better, baby, when your man is gone.
Like a
storm. I got me a mean old lady with a heart like a block of stone. Whatever it is, I just can't leave that girl alone. Whatever it is, I just can't leave that girl alone.
Yeah.
That's some King Biscuit Boy. Not too many people know King Biscuit Boy. He was from Canada.
Wow.
He was,
I don't know.
Isn't
he
was, the King Biscuit?
Played with Crowbar.
Remember that? The King
there was
Biscuit.
The,
Flower.
Yeah, there was the King Biscuit Flower Hour. That was a radio show back in the 70s.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't know if that had anything to do with this guy.
I
don't remember his real name, but he was a really good harmonica player.
Mary.
Yeah.
There's been several King Biscuit Boys.
Oh, okay.
Oh, really?
Yeah. The, one of the original was back in the, let me explain this right. The reason he was King Biscuit Boy, because of the radio station, they advertised biscuits and flour and crap like that.
Okay.
All right, we're going to do Born Under a Bad Sign.
Who?
Some more Albert King. And Cream, we kind of mix up the two. Born under a bad sign. I've been tired since I began to crawl. Never one for bad luck. For bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all. Ain't learned to read, I can't even write. My whole life's born under a bad sign. I've been tired since I began to crawl. If I want for bad luck, since I began to
on under a pass sign. On under a real bad sign. Right on cue, Brent. Right when I was saying something about crawling, you were crawling across, trying to stay under the camera.
Yes.
He was trying to stay under the camera.
Yes. What I was trying to think of a minute ago, King Biscuit Boy was originally Sonny Boy Williamson the second. It gets really complicated out of the water.
No one
trained
that all came from
a river. All right, you want to try a little Wayne and Buttigieg?
She's walking through the crowd with a circus light that's running wild. Moonbeams and butterflies and fairy tales. That's all she ever thinks about. Riding with the wind. When I'm sad, she comes to me with a thousand smiles. She gets me free. It's all right, she says, it's all right. You're taking anything that you want from me. When I'm sad, she comes to me with a thousand smiles. She gets me free. It's all right, she says, it's all right. We'll take anything that you want from me. Yeah, baby, anything. Thank you.
pieces make an island. I might raise a little sand. Cause I'm a voodoo child, voodoo child. The Lord knows I'm a voodoo child. I didn't mean to take up all your sweet time. Even run back to your woman these days. I didn't mean to take up all your sweet time. Even run back to your woman these days. Need you no more in this world. I'll meet you in the next one. And don't be late. Yeah, don't be late, baby. Cause I'm a voodoo child, voodoo child. The Lord knows I'm a voodoo child.
What's up?
1 minute. I gotta figure it out.
Okay.
Let's try for What Passes for Love in the key of G.
What key is it?
G. G, like here.
I know that, I'm just seeing if you do.
Lest we forget, bridges are
are burning, lest we forget the tides you're turning. Please forgive us and some help from above. We got all we need, but it's never enough. And I'm sorry to say, I'm amazed at what passes for love. Brother to brother, now please take our hand. Father and mother, won't you try to understand? We learn kind of slow, but these lessons are tough. This house will survive if we hang on long enough. And I'm sorry to say, I'm amazed at what passes for love. Too many riches, too many fools, too many heroes with too many rules. We fuel the fires of the wars we wage. Cry of anger without light, behind the shadows, the darker night. With seeds of rage and tears of rage.
I just sent a message to Rick Glue to ask him if he played keys.
Ooh.
Yeah? So maybe we can do some Black Friday.
Yeah.
If he'll do that.
We're going to be the Blues and
Yeah.